Mercedes-Benz A-Class. This is already the third generation of the A-Class. The W176, as Mercedes calls it, was first introduced back in 2012. It went through a facelift in 2016. And this particular car is a 2013 model. The W176 A-Class. It may have been around for a while now, but this compact design still looks very modern. This car is equipped with the AMG Line exterior package. In combination with its black color and red accents, it's a true example of how a sporty hatchback should look like. Let's move on to the interior of the A-Class. This A-Class is equipped with the AMG Line interior package, which gives it nice sports seats, red stitching on the seats and also on the dashboard and doors. You've got even red around the air vents. And what I like most about the red accents are the red seat belts. What about the material used in this interior? Well, on the upper part of the A-Class interior, you've got nice soft touch materials. Those soft touch materials also continue in the doors. But on the lower part of the A-Class, you start feeling harder plastics and less nicer materials. This inlay here is a carbon look plastic. The material on those could have been better, but on the upper part of the interior, the materials feel nice. Well, the screen right there is the multimedia interface for the Garmin navigation system. The competitors, like the BMW 1 Series, had a better multimedia interface. Let's talk about the seats. As I mentioned before, we've got the optional memory seats, which result into many ways of adjustment. The leather used for the seats, it's actually pretty good. It feels nice. And the seats themselves, they give very good side support, so they really hug you when cornering. But I wish that they could have gone a little bit lower to give it a more sporty driving position. Space in the rear seats is decent if you're under 1 meter and 80 centimeters, but if you're above that, you'll struggle with headroom and also with legroom. But what I dislike about the rear seats are the lower part of the seats are very short. So almost half of your upper leg isn't on the seat. Other competitors in this class offer much better rear seats. Storage space is also decent, with lots of compartments to put a lot of stuff in. This optional panoramic roof really brightens up the interior. Yes, overall, the interior has a nice design. Some parts are starting to show its age, of course. Mostly the navigation system, the multimedia interface. But other than that, it's still a very nice interior. This is the third generation of the A-Class. The prior two generations were more like MPV cars that seniors would buy. But this third generation went through a revolution in design. It became a hatchback and it's much more appealing for the younger generation. Some of the A-Class's competitors are the BMW 1 Series, the Audi A3, and the VW Golf. About the drivetrain of the A-Class. This car is the A250 model, which comes with a inline 4-cylinder petrol engine that produces 211 horsepower and 350 Nm of torque. It is driven through a 7-speed dual clutch transmission, which drives the front wheels only in this case. And optionally, you could get 4MATIC. Talk about how the A-Class drives. Let's start with the steering. The steering response is pretty good. It reacts quite directly to your input. Steering weight is also not too light, but steering feel, the steering gives you a sense of disconnection with the road. So that's a downside of the steering in this car. And also you don't feel where the center is, so yeah, the steering could have been a lot better in my opinion. Let's start talking about the suspension of this car. This car is equipped with the optional sport suspension, which comes with the AMG Line exterior package. Well, in generally it's pretty firm, as you can see. But it isn't very uncomfortable. It's doable as a daily driver, but on bad surfaces like this, you feel, of course, the vibration. But on the upper hand, when cornering, this car stays decently flat. So if you want a more comfortable suspension setup, you should avoid the AMG line suspension. Let's talk about the transmission. This is a 7-speed dual clutch transmission. It is adjustable by pressing this button down here. It's now in eco mode. We can put it to sport, and you have a manual setting. Let's start with the eco mode. Well, in eco mode, the transmission shifts pretty fast. Let's try to downshift. Also decent downshifting time. Let's put the transmission in sport mode. The engine drops down a couple of gears. Throttle response improves. You even hear a turbo spool. Wow! And on downshift, the exhaust pops. And the exhaust makes a very nice sound in sport. Let go of the throttle, that burbly sound really enhances the driving experience of this car. Exhaust makes everything good now. In sport transmission mode. Let's open the panoramic sunroof so you can hear how the exhaust and engine sounds. Wow, an upshift. The exhaust sounds very good, it pops, and when you let go of the gas, when it downshifts, it pops as well. Wow. This four-cylinder sounds pretty good. And with 211 horsepower, it's pretty fast as well. Now let's put the transmission into the manual mode. Mode, the transmission reacts pretty well to the pedal shifts. When you try to downshift more than one gear, there is a lag. Second, third, fourth, yeah. When you shift one gear at a time, it's very fast, but when you try to shift two or more gears, then it has a very big delay on it. So let's go to fourth, third, second. That was a pretty big delay there. Yeah, this engine pulls pretty good. The exhaust sounds very good. Second gear, manual mode. Let's fully accelerate. So what's my verdict on the A-Class? Granted, it's not the most sporty driving car in its class, or the most comfortable or spacious. But this A250 with its nice inline 4-cylinder petrol engine and its lovely sounding exhaust sure have been a joy to drive in.